Squirmy, Wormy, here we go. Another Interloper run. Now last time I said that the Firemaster, level 3 fire starting skill at the start, is better than a Fishing Machine, but I take it back. I think a Fishing Machine's actually better. So I'm gonna take that one again. Alright, let's go. So we can start at any time of day. And I don't think you can start in every region, but any regions. Alright, so where am I? Alright. So this is Desolation Point. Now I haven't established, but I think it's the case that if you start at Desolation Point, there can't be a hammer spawn in the region that you start in, if there's a forge in that same region. I'm not certain about that, but I think that's true. Alright, so it's an okay starting region, good time of day, it's a pretty lucky start. Sometimes you just start in like a region you don't recognize in the middle of the night, and if that happens, I think you actually just fucked. Alright, a couple of good shots there on the rabbits. Okay, so we'll see if we can find a hammer. I'm also gonna need a hacksaw there. So that's what I'm gonna do at the start. Hammer and a hacksaw. And I'm just gonna probably hit up a couple of the regions and not stick around for long because
can't feel my feet.
Like I probably will need to come back here. But I don't have what I need to stay here at the moment. Okay. So yeah, at the start, you're really on a clock. You should have a great sense of urgency. Man, my temperature is still dropping even inside. That is rough. Okay. Yeah, wait, didn't I fuck that up last time? And harvest the, like, I almost made the same mistake. Like, I can't harvest the rabbits I just picked up in here. Because of the temperature. Which is how I dropped like 40% of my health at the beginning of the last run. So, we're going somewhere else. Up there, no doubt. Hibernia. Okay, nothing there. I'm gonna run because my fatigue's really high, and it's like midday, so I can definitely afford, actually it's not just I can afford to, it's actually desirable for me to burn some fatigue, so I can sleep through the night. I gotta have two rabbits to harvest, so it wouldn't be a completely unproductive time if I did have to stop. or if I had to, like, stay awake at night. Really see very well here.
That'll come in handy.
You know what? It actually will come in handy. Yeah, it's kind of sucks. Cause I can't see what I'm doing. Can't see the containers to harvest or anything. I'm sure I'm missing stuff in here. Did find gloves, so that's good. Alright, I can't see properly in here, so I'm gonna just head back to the whale processing thing.
Never felt so cold in my life.
The wolf. There should be some loot in here. My cats are play fighting on the thing. I'm not sure if that's showing up on that. On the microphone. Yo, I gotta find some clothes. I'm still freezing even indoors. This is not good. I feel like zero, but it means I'm still dropping health. Even if they're like just, you know, 1 degree. That'd make all the difference. Okay. Well, we'll put them in this order. It didn't make a difference, it's only 0.2 degrees. Temperature benefit there. T-shirt does almost nothing. I mean, it is low durability, but I was hoping it'd at least tick me over into positive temperature territory. With a bit of luck, I'll find another piece of clothing in here. Or even just some cloth so I can repair what I've got. Item. Not much fuel in it. Can't see anything on there. Doesn't mean there isn't anything. Checking the containers with the lantern on, just checking out in the open. Okay. So I can't get into that container until I get a hacksaw. Can't get through there though. I'm running just to save the lantern fuel. Let's turn, that's kind of useless at the moment. Alright, I think that's it. That's all I need out of that. and a flame, which is a fire starter. And also a get the fuck off me wolf. Alright. Something good.
What have we here?
Nope. Alright, so I guess I gotta go to the trailers now. Check these. That I can't get into those lockers. Right, I'm gonna check this one first. I mustn't forget to get some tinder. Alright, now we're recovering temperature. That's great. It's not so much about the temperature that I actually recover, but more about like that I'm not dropping health while I'm inside. Okay. So I have one tinder, but that's definitely not going to be enough. Fuel, I got a little bit of fuel. Alright, nothing for it, I'm just going to keep on rolling. Head to the cave, even if I have to use a flare to get through it. So I'm like mega on the clock right now. Like I gotta find clothes, or you know, minimum find some cloth so I'm not dropping health while I'm even indoors.
Freezing.
The urgency is also good, because you know it gets quite cold quite quickly.
Could end up being useful. I need to find food. Thank you. thirsty.
Sorry, was my mic muted that whole time? That is terribly unfortunate.
I could eat anything right now.
Alright, definitely don't need 8 charcoal. I'll take like 3. I'm just gonna let myself starve.
Stomach is eating itself.
Right now it's pretty early in the day. So I do need to be a little bit conservative with my fatigue. Right, so I've hit all of the main structures in this region. So now I'm just gonna leave. Again, I'm going to drop a little bit of health to cold on the way out. I'll head out on the coast, do a little bit of beachcombing on the way. So I head like along this little section of coast. I'll check out Katie's secluded corner because I'm close to it now anyway. Any kind of like fish or something like that would be all good right now. Birch bark, some firewood, nothing crazy yet. I'd like some cloth or something along those lines. Sapling, that's pretty good. Very good, actually.
Need to find some place to escape this cold.
So yeah, at the beginning of an Interloper run, there's a great sense of urgency that I feel I was somewhat lacking in the last one. The urgency now for me comes from the fact that my clothes are so terrible that I really can't stay outside for very long. Like, I only got that far before my temperature's at 0.
Just the one lay down.
in other circumstances I would stay to get and harvest the deer. Rabbit if I can hit one. I can find my my rock again. So I have no way to cut that down.
This will come in handy.
Alright, do something like that. Take one more shot at a rabbit. This one. Ah, too high. There we go. That's maybe most of a day's calories right there. Starvation mode anyway. Alright, I'm not sure I can mount and go down that side. But I think this side you can. Looks promising. Yeah, that's fine. Carry two rocks just as long as my my carry weight's still nice and low. Yeah, I've got 10 kilos of extra carry weight. Pretty sure if you throw a rock at a wolf and like basically hit it, but without aiming, because if you aim it'll charge you. But if you can basically just sort of no-scope the wolf with the rock, I think it has a chance to run away. Carry two rocks just for that reason. Alright, I like to keep 9 full-man speared lichen on me. Because that's enough for me to make 3 dressings. I don't make them into dressings because they weigh more as a dressing than they do as the ingredient. It's one of the only crafted things in the game that I like that. And I don't bother like picking up any more than 9. Once I have 9, I just stop picking them up and leave them. I'm also going to drop the sapling just inside. So I'm likely to come back at some point to do forging. Like, it might not be to this region, but in case I do. Better than my current gloves. They are warmer though. think. A little bit warmer. I mean, honestly, that seems okay. Like, that's... Anyway, at max, that'll be like half a degree, half a degree. And this looks like 1 degree, half a degree. It's like half a degree for 0.15. That's what, that's like 3.5 degrees per kilo. That's pretty good. So we'll break that down. Repair that and hopefully it works. Nope. Oh well. Managed to drop some carry weight anyway. Right now, I don't really have any time to fuck around in this cave. I've only got a third of a liter of lantern fuel. So I'm gonna have to go quickly. Probably justifies running. Fuck. Okay, now there can be some tools and stuff down these extra little tunnels. Okay, all this coal is very useful. Helps me defend myself against wolves a little bit too. So pry bar gets the wolves off you a bit faster. Well, actually quite a lot faster than hands.
Stuff to carry.
You know, I'm not that mad about carrying shitloads of coal. I think running here is not gonna cost me that much either. My fatigue to the time of day is looking pretty good. So we got through there using about half of our lantern fuel. It's not too bad. Alright, I do have a bit of time. I'd like to warm up a bit before I go. So I'll do something like this. It's a bit more than I needed. That's okay. Drop those. What have I got for tinder? I've got 4 tinders. I will drop that one. Anything that's like really excessive? Just a few, I think. So you know, 35 coal. That's quite a lot. So we'll drop pretty much all the sticks. We'll keep one. So we've got one of these still. Feel okay about that. Give myself a little bit of carry weight to mess with. If I'm ever coming back through that cave, I'll have plenty of... I'll be picking up plenty of coal on the way through, so I'm not that concerned about dropping coal off on the way. Look at the corpse for a second. Okay, I probably don't need to run now. Most of the point, I probably shouldn't. Now the thing is, I don't have good structures. The next good structure is probably like... Where the fuck is that rabbit going? Like, because I've got this structure, and then it's kind of like... coastal highway structures, basically. Well, that was a pretty good shot. Just lead the target, eh? Bandage, that's good. I don't have any good ways of getting wolves off me. So basically we'll just have to outrun them. I also don't have any firelighters at all. Which is a concern. Good old instant fog. I'm not gonna pick up the sticks because I'll end up just dropping them at a location anyway.
I wonder if I can drop any of this gear.
Okay, excess gear. What do we not need? I don't want to be carrying around an extra kilo and a half. I was thinking about carrying the fur firewood in case I found a hammer that was on low condition. Then I could repair it up. Now I could kick that wolf off that rabbit, but I'd rather him have the rabbit as a distraction while I head around to the little house here. Alright, so I'm gonna have to evade this wolf. I'm just gonna run around him. Decision I have to make now. Actually, no, there's no decision. I was going to say the decision I have to make is, do I sleep in this house or do I try and make it to the coastal highway house? But I don't really think that's a decision because there's no bed. So what I'll do, because I've got temperature here, I'll sleep an hour. I won't recover any health, but I'll recover some fatigue. I'll search this house and then I'll try and make it to whichever house that is, Missing Thrift Homestead, or Jackrabbit Island, whichever one it is that's closer to sort of where I come into that region. Find some clothes. Wow, gotta be socks here, right? Hey, that was just a joke, but it actually is. Okay. So the reason that I slept in that car without recovering any health is because now, what should I do? Because now my fatigue is higher and the day is later, so I can afford to run. I don't need to run right now, so I'm gonna save the fatigue. No firelighters, so I don't need to run right now. Because it's reasonably warm. You know, only minus 8. So just gonna make it into Coastal Highway, go up to the island house, and that's where I'll sleep tonight. Coastal Highway is a pretty nice region. A lot of structures, a lot of resources. Kind of dangerous, a lot of wolves. Yeah, so I'm mostly looking for the tools that I need to do forging. So that would be a hammer and a hacksaw. Okay, 0.6 kilos. All right, car with absolutely nothing in it. Sticks. Actually, there might be houses here. I think it just sort of happens randomly if any of these houses are actually sort of have an inside part of them, or if they're all destroyed. If I can get into any of them, I will. I'll sleep there instead. Alright, no luck. Maybe it can't happen in Interloper. So I think this is the third or fourth time I've Composter and Interloper, and all three houses have been destroyed. Maybe that's an Interloper thing. Alright, I'll drop sticks as soon as I need to. It's gonna be a little while before I actually need to use the feathers, but alright, so there is the bear at that spawn. There are rabbits around here too, right? What a shot that would have been. Oh well. Actually, I can't pick that up. Oh, I can. So I just gotta dodge this bear. I'm gonna head up this way.
Die if I don't warm up soon.
Think I'm gonna have to run and make that in time. Don't want to be tussling with a bear right now. Yeah, it's gonna be a while before I need the crow's feathers, but I'm gonna pick them up anyway. Because they can take a while to accumulate enough. Okay. Made it to Misanthropes. So yeah, this is where I'm staying tonight. What I really want is matches.
That guy who drank his own pee doesn't seem so crazy right now.
There's lots of cloth in this house, which is a great blessing. Yeah, felt weird to say that. Felt kind of religious, which I'm definitely not. Come on, clothes. Hey, that's good. That's one of the best best things for that slot. And it's high durability too, which is nice. Very nice, very nice.
I need to drop something.
Alright, cool. Let's break down those. I'm not going to repair the t-shirt because it sucks, but I am going to put it in here. I'll repair the rest up. Right now it's just a matter of killing time. Let's see how well we can navigate inside the house. Without the lantern, like, sort of reference off the where the windows are. So even if you can't see your surroundings, you can kind of guess where everything is just based on, like, you can see the shape of the window. If you can see the shape of the window, and you know how you're moving, you figure out where to go. It's right here, I know the layout of the place, so if I get to here, now I'm in the kitchen. Do that one without a tool. See, I just kill time doing something as useful as I can do. With no light. a lot of curtains in this place. There we go. That's how you do it. Oh, I guess I can harvest this too. Another 2 hours. Kill lots of time with that. Alright, now I'm gonna eat 675 calories. Alright, how should I do it? I think I should do it. Right, these two, that's like 700. So I'll just stop drinking this, like, here or something. I'm a fucking god. Fucking nailed that. 675 calories, get my 10 hours. And, we just ticked over an hour in this episode. Made some good progress for one episode. So, I'm gonna break it there and pick it up in the next one.